Hi, everybody. Thank you all so much for being here. I really appreciate having you all come out on a Sunday night. Happy International Jazz Day to those of you who celebrate, and thanks for celebrating it by listening to a classical trumpet recital. I figured I'd stay on stage kind of in between pieces and talk a little bit about each piece, just because I really like all the music that I'm playing and I want to share information about it. So. That first piece was written by Swiss composer Heinrich Sudermeister in 1950. Sudermeister is a sort of lesser-known composer. Is known for his 8 operas and a number of pieces for stage, radio, and television. He was one of the kind of leading composers of writing works for television and radio during his career. So. This piece, the piece that you just heard, was the only piece that he wrote for solo trumpet. It kind of became a sort of staple of trumpet literature in the last 70 years or so. Next piece that we're playing is an original composition of mine titled Autumn Morning. I wanted to challenge myself to write a lyrical piece featuring the flugelhorn and piano as a duet. I think that flugelhorn is a little bit of an underappreciated instrument in the brass world, so I wanted to play a little bit more of it. So there are 3 distinct parts and 3 distinct tonalities throughout this piece, and I wanted to focus rather than structuring it around a traditional form or harmonic series or anything like that. I took a method of serialism, often referred to as Stravinsky verticals. Can come in.
I love that.
Okay. Often referred to as Stravinsky verticals, just involves taking a number of pitches and rotating them and transposing them, and that's as specific as I'll get, because I wrote it last year and I forgot how I did it. So, this is Autumn Morning.
Thank you.
wonderful Dr. Han on piano. All right, this next piece that I'll be playing, I found earlier this semester when I was looking through trying to round out my recital program, and I came across this piece. And it's a beautiful lyrical piece, also features flugelhorn, so I'm playing flugelhorn more than I think any other trumpet on this recital. This next piece is written by composer Andrea Hobson. She currently is based in Germany, but lived for a while in South Africa. And the title of the piece, Silver-Backed Fox, is inspired by the only species of fox that is native to South Africa. The silver-backed fox, or cape fox, not to be confused with Dr. Belzer's piece from last night. I did realize that, yeah. Been involved in a couple of premieres of pieces about foxes recently. So, this piece was originally commissioned by the trumpeter Jennifer Oliverio for her 2021 album called Enigma. And the piece sort of follows a loose narrative. The silver-backed fox is nocturnal, and so the piece begins at dusk and follows the fox as it goes hunting and just kind of goes about its life as a nocturnal animal. So the piece uses a lot of minor pentatonic and blues scales to sort of convey that. So, please enjoy Silver-Backed Fox.
Thank you.
take a short break then. Trumpets. Thank you. Classical ensembles or taken any classical lessons since high school. So it was a bit of a culture shock to come here and do all of that suddenly. But it's been a wonderful time and I really appreciate the patience and the dedication of the faculty here and all of the opportunities that I've had to play a lot of wonderful music. So when I first came here, I got to meet Dr. David Wharton. Some of you might be familiar with him. And Dr. Wharton is kind of a badass on the Baroque trumpet. And this was an instrument that, full disclosure, I had no idea existed until last fall, two falls ago, yeah. No idea that it existed. But doing a little bit of research on the history of the instrument, the modern trumpet, as we know it, has only really been popular in the last 200 years or so. The first valved instruments debuted in 1827, and before then, a lot of the earlier instruments looked a lot like this. So much longer and harder to play. To be specific, but this next piece is a Baroque piece written by Philip Jakob Rittler, who was a Roman Catholic priest and Baroque composer. This piece was written in 1678 and originally was written for two trumpets, a violin, three violas, violone, and a harpsichord. So we've condensed that a little bit. And at this point, I would like to welcome back to the stage Dr. Hahn, playing a different instrument this time. But yeah, please welcome Dr. Hahn. And also, joining, yeah, everybody, Dr. David Wharton. And we are lucky enough to get to play this with two amazing violinists, Ricky Kubiak and Giovanna Volpi. Who not only agreed to play this, but to play it at the standard Baroque tuning, which is 4:15, which is obnoxious.
Yeah.
say a few thank yous to everybody who, everybody who has helped me along the way and all of those things, and give my face more time to rest. So, first of all, thank you to you all for being here. Again, I appreciate you spending a Sunday evening listening to some trumpet music. First of all, thank you to Dr. Hahn for his artistry and cooperation and patience at times, so thank you, Dr. Hahn. Skipping all these pieces, okay. Thank you to my family for being here and watching, whether they're here or elsewhere, and for their boundless support through the years, and for being wonderful. Thank you to my friends for being here, and all of your wonderful support, and all of the awesome music that we've gotten to play together, and for being yourselves. A few more. thank you to Tim Worth for helping provide the harpsichord and tune the harpsichord, very finicky instrument to tune, and for all of the work that he does at this university. So thank you to Tim. Also, a big thank you to Dee for their help today in setting up the stage and moving things around, and all the work that they and the other stagehands do at this university. So thank you. As well as the folks back there recording, I think it was Monica when I came in, but I can't see anymore because the screen's dark, but thank you. And lastly, I'd just like to take a moment to thank all of the wonderful mentors that I've had throughout my time here and throughout all my time playing music. The last 2 years have gone by really quickly, and I'm eternally grateful to the support and patience and care and attention that I've gotten from all of the faculty here. So thank you to Dr. Wharton, and especially for his playing on the last piece, so thank you, Dr. Wharton. As well as some other mentors that I've had here, so Dr. Ben Markley, Dr. Andy Wheelock, Professor Catherine Smith, Dan Watt, Alan Harvey, Dr. Bob Belzer, Dr. Michael Griffith, Dr. Guzzo, and anybody else who I've gotten the opportunity to work with. I am eternally grateful for all of the support and patience and learning that I've gotten to do here. So, this last piece was written by the French cornet virtuoso and pedagogue and composer Jean-Baptiste Arban. The Arban's Complete Conservatory Method for Cornet was the first actual book that I bought that talked about trumpet playing. And I still haven't played all the way through it, so it's a lot of wonderful information. And this is one of the many cornet solos that Arban wrote. And this particular arrangement is done by Donald Hansberger, that was originally planned for the 1987 album Carnival, with the Eastman Wind Ensemble and Wynton Marsalis as the soloist. So, this piece has been something that I've always wanted to play since I first started playing the trumpet, and so I thought it would be a fitting way to end my recital. So, please enjoy Fantasy Brilliant.